three young siblings from Emmett, Idaho, went missing on three separate occasions. In September of 2020, 17-year-old Tristan Sexton went missing. In October, 14-year-old Taylor Summers went missing. Now, in April of 2020, 8-year-old Taryn Summers has gone missing as well. Police have now arrested the grandma of these three children for homicide. Tristan Connor Sexton, Taylor Summers, and Taryn Summers are three siblings from Emmett, Idaho. Emmett is known for being one of the largest cities in the area. And this isn't the city's first go-around in terms of terrible crimes that have been committed there. On the evening of September 10th, 2020, 17-year-old Tristan was last seen a short distance away from Airport Road near Highway 52. It wouldn't be 30 days before his younger sister, Taylor, would go missing from the exact location as well. After they vanished, no one heard from these teens again. There were theories that began to circulate claiming that the teens may have run away, possibly together, but the evidence surrounding this was trivial at best. Sadly, around the time that this news broke, the case didn't receive much attention from the media pretty much at all. It seemed like it had just been swept under the rug in favor of news coverage about the pandemic that I'm sure we're all sick of hearing about at this point. It's now been more than 7 months since the two teens disappeared. And it nearly seemed like the case was going to run cold. That is, until a bit of news broke in mid-April of 2020, just a couple weeks ago at the time of filming this. On April 12th, Taryn Summers went missing, also in the city of Emmett. Where did she go missing? Well, you guessed it, at the intersection of Airport Road and Highway 52, just like her two siblings. What makes Taryn's case a little bit more shocking is that she was just 8 years old when she went missing. While police initially believed they were just about to hit a dead end in the cases of these two other children, Taryn's disappearance blew the case wide open, and all eyes began to turn towards members of the family. The theory about the teens being runaways was now dead in the water, as there was virtually no chance that an 8-year-old would or could disappear of her own free will. It's also just a little bit too convenient that all of the children disappeared from the exact location, within 7 months of each other. Sadly, the worst possible scenario would play out just a few days ago when police announced that they'd found a body at a home located at 1666 Airport Road. I'm gonna do my best to keep some of the awful details of this case out of this video because I like to keep these videos as family-friendly as possible. But police say they visited the home of the grandmother of the children, Connie Ann Smith. The grandmother was the first to report Taryn Summers missing, but the grandmother was insistent that the little girl had just run away. This obviously didn't sit well with police, but they entertained this idea because they didn't have any other further evidence. Police had visited Connie's home on multiple occasions, and it seemed like Connie was more than willing to cooperate with their investigation. What makes the case a bit strange, though, is that when officers entered their home, they noticed a small patch of carpet in Taryn's room had been completely removed. It was cut out, and the remnants of it were apparently burned by Connie. It doesn't seem like police were initially too concerned about this, though, because Connie's explanation kind of made a lot of sense if you really give her at least a little bit of credit here. According to the grandma, Taryn had soiled herself on the carpet, but then proceeded to spread the contents all around so that it would be nearly impossible to clean the carpet. I've gotta admit, it seems a bit strange that an 8-year-old would do this, but as an 8-year-old, I was a bit of a freak, so it's not completely unbelievable that this could have possibly happened. When officers continued to search the young girl's room, though, they began to notice that things just didn't add up the way they should. One of the most telling and gruesome details was when they found a tiny spot of blood on one of the walls in the bedroom. This tiny detail blew the case open, and immediately, the focus began to shift to the grandma of the two young girls and the young boy. At first, it seemed like the grandma couldn't come up with an adequate explanation for the blood, and this led officers to search every square inch of her home, and they eventually made their way out into the front yard where they searched her car. They asked her to unlock the doors of her Lexus, and inside they found a black trash bag. This is where I'm going to stop. If you want to learn more details about this case, you can definitely search it online. Everything you could possibly want to know is there, but I can't say I'd really recommend digging any further into the more disturbing details of this case. The grandma was obviously immediately charged with first-degree murder, but it seems like these charges were altered later on, and she's now facing a plethora of other charges, possibly in addition to homicide, but also possibly in exchange for homicide. Considering the case is so recent, we don't really know what this may mean for the fate of the other children, though. Police have not really revealed any further information about the case, and obviously the grandma isn't speaking to anyone until she goes to trial. Strangely, we also don't know where the parents have been throughout this entire process. As it stands, none of the articles I've been able to find have mentioned the parents, not even once. The story does have somewhat of a silver lining, though, if you could call it that. According to East Idaho News, the two other children have been located and they seem to be fine. I know I literally just said that we don't really know much else about the other children, but I say that because it seems like reporters are repeatedly backtracing their steps and updating details on this case after they've already been reported. So until I personally see video footage or photos of these children, I'm personally a bit too hesitant to say that they are alive and well, and I certainly wouldn't want to report that in this video when the details are still so fresh. With this possibility in mind, it definitely makes sense that the other two children could have genuinely just run away. But I still find that really odd considering they all disappeared from the exact location within just 7 months of each other. Why did the other children want to flee if that is the case? Is it possible that they felt like their grandmother's home wasn't safe? And if so, though, why would they leave their little sister behind? And why would they have evaded all contact with police for such a long period of time? And why would the family have kept this a secret? I don't want to go too much further on the details of this case, considering that they're all continuing to pour in, but it seems like Connie Smith has not yet entered a plea in the case, and some articles seem to suggest that police may have dropped the initial homicide charge, like I mentioned a moment ago. I don't typically cover stories that are this recent because there's always such a major lack of details, but we will just have to wait and see, I guess, to know how this case unfolds in the end. There's so many unanswered questions, but I can't seem to figure out why the other two children would have run away at such similar times, especially when their younger sister met her fate just a few months later. That really just doesn't bode well for the grandma. Something just isn't adding up here, but I imagine we will get our answers soon enough, even if they aren't answers we particularly want to hear. But that's gonna be the video for today, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm sorry that there wasn't some sort of resolution to this case. At the moment, it's hard to say it's unsolved, but there's just so much that still has to go on here. There's so many details that have to come out, and I'm sure this case is gonna be, it's gonna take quite a long time for it to be officially resolved. You know, court cases in America can take years, so it could be quite a while before we actually find out what truly happened to these children, if we ever do actually find out. But that's gonna be where we have to leave it for today. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. If you loved it, maybe consider sharing, subscribing, or clicking that blue join button below to really show your support for the channel. But I've been Ty Knotts. You guys have been lovely, and I'll catch you in the next video.